History will be watching what happens tomorrow. Black and brown Americans will be watching what happens tomorrow. In 50 years, students will read about what happens tomorrow and know whether our leaders had the integrity to do the right thing.
On this Martin Luther King holiday, his family worries about the future, even while looking back at the man who was murdered fighting for equality over half a century ago. The Kings led a march across the Frederick Douglass Memorial Bridge here in Washington today, demanding the Senate pass voting rights legislation. And this comes on the eve of when the Senate will begin debate on this issue. Now, over the holiday weekend, the Kings brought their message to Arizona. So did Donald Trump and the return of the big lie. Our Donie O'Sullivan saw firsthand how their visions of free and fair elections could not be further apart.
No celebration without legislation.
We all have a voice in this country in which we live. And voting is that opportunity that we have.
This Martin Luther King Jr. Day weekend in Arizona, a battle for the future of American democracy.
We wanted to come on this day because there's also a senator, Senator Sinema, who seems to be blocking democracy instead of being on the side of advancing democracy. Senator Sinema!
The King family here calling on Arizona Democratic Senator Kyrsten Sinema to stand up for voters' rights.
She says she wants voting rights, but how do you want voting rights without creating a path for that to happen? That is inconsistent, and that is unacceptable.
Sinema and fellow Democratic Senator Joe Manchin of West Virginia are blocking the passage of a pair of voting rights bills aimed at countering some of the restrictive voting measures enacted by Republicans at the state level. Sinema says she is supportive of the bills, but not in favor of changing Senate rules to get them passed.
And while I continue to support these bills, I will not support separate actions that worsen the underlying disease of division infecting our country.
That stance, music to the ears of some Trump supporters this weekend, on hand at a rally for Trump in Sinema's home state.
God bless Kyrsten Sinema and what she's doing, you know?
Kyrsten Sinema, good for her. You know, she's our representative. She represents the state. She's not along party lines. She's what's good for the country.
Do you like Kyrsten Sinema?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. And Manchin.
And Manchin.
In fact, I have sent emails to them encouraging them to stand up and do what's right for the people of Arizona.
Those supporters in line for Trump's rally Saturday, also in attendance a hodgepodge of election deniers like MyPillow CEO Mike Lindell, Congressman Paul Gosar, and even Ali Alexander, one of the main organizers of Stop the Steal, who went into hiding after the insurrection and was recently called in front of the January 6th House Select Committee.
Hey Ali, are you worried that you might get indicted?
Thank you, Arizona. Thank you. Thank
Trump
you.
Here giving his support to two election deniers who are running to control elections in the state. Carrie Lake is running for governor.
There's a few other people I'd like to send right down to the prison down here in Florence. Anybody who was involved in that corrupt, shady, shoddy election of 2020, lock them up.
And Mark Fincham, who previously said he was an oath keeper and is now running for Secretary of State.
Donald Trump won.
Fincham has echoed QAnon-type conspiracy theories about elected officials.
There's a lot of people involved in a pedophile network and the distribution of children. And unfortunately, there's a whole lot of elected officials that are involved in that.
And he continues to falsely attack the legitimacy of the 2020 election here in Arizona.
I look forward to the day that we set aside an irredeemably flawed election. That's the election of 2020. With all the evidence we have, the Arizona election should be decertified with cause by the legislature.
That's part of a national trend. A Washington Post tally finding 163 Republicans who have embraced Trump's false claims are running for statewide positions that would give them authority over the administration of elections. Arizona's current Secretary of State, Katie Hobbs, now running for governor.
I think we are really at a defining moment. I mean, in 2020,
democracy prevailed, and 2020 and after 2020, democracy prevailed because people on both sides of the aisle did their jobs. And what we're seeing now is this just multi-pronged attack. And one of those prongs is Trump trying to instill his loyalists into key positions that have some level of determination over how elections are certified and conducted. And that's pretty scary.
We will pass this bill.
And on this Martin Luther King Jr. Day weekend, his 13-year-old granddaughter, following in her grandfather's footsteps, with a warning for today.
I think it's so important to vote, and it's so important to have the right to vote, because right now our country is at stake.
And Donie is joining us now. Donie, as always, great report, taking us right into the middle of things there. You know, just this month, the Maricopa County Recorder, who is a Republican, who defeated a Democrat in 2020, debunked 76 out of 77 claims by the so-called cyber ninjas. That is the group, of course, that carried out that so-called fraudit and is now shutting down. And he said, quote, "The truth is the Maricopa County 2020 election was not stolen from Donald Trump." I wonder if any of that penetrates into the consciousness of Trump supporters that you spoke with.
Yeah, I mean, that Republican election official is an example of somebody that many Trump supporters and Trump himself, of course, wants to get rid of. I did think what was quite notable about this trip to Arizona, you know, for so much of the past year, we have heard outlandish and really, really crazy conspiracy theories about voting, whether it was, you know, Hugo Chavez voting machines swaying the election for Donald Trump and pieces of paper from China some way changing votes. A lot of that stuff seemed to die down, at least based on the people we had spoken to. And they were back talking about more generally the election being stolen and talking more along the lines of the restrictive voting measures that are being brought in by Republicans at a state level. So the conspiracy theories seem to have, the more fringe conspiracy theories, I guess, have eased a bit. And now the talking points have really began to align with these restrictive measures from Republicans. But of course, it is all still very much based on a big lie.
Because as you see these restrictive measures that are being put in place by Republicans, Trump supporters actually feel, and they're buying into this line, that they are being disenfranchised, Donie.
Yeah, and you know, it was kind of striking. We started off Saturday morning at that march with the King family and speaking to an elderly African-American woman, a voter in Arizona. And, you know, for her, the fear is real. What she is seeing, it is based in history. It's echoes of Jim Crow, what they are seeing with these restrictions that are being brought in now. On the other side of things, there are people at the Trump rally who are fearful. I think some of them know better. Some of them know that this is a lie and it's BS and it's a talking point. But a lot of them really have been bought so far into this world of conspiracy that they genuinely do believe that American democracy is a joke. And it's a very, very sad place for an American to be in that mindset, particularly because of lies. So there is fear on both sides of this debate, but obviously with much different motivations. Brianna?
Yeah, Donie O'Sullivan, thank you so much for that.